In this video, I'm gonna show you in a few simple steps how you can make your own PlayStation 5 SCUF controller. And I'm also gonna give away this SCUF controller since I switched to keyboard and mouse. So make sure to watch all the way till the end for more information about that. And as always, there are timestamps in the timeline and in the description below so you can easily guide yourself throughout this video. And if you ever come back to the video, once you're gonna build your own PlayStation 5 SCUF controller, you can skip ahead to the specific part of the video you are looking for. As for the supplies, you probably have most of it already at home. If not, you can always borrow it from your neighbors or buy it yourself, because most of it will not be expensive. And you can also use an alternative for most of the tools. You are going to need the PlayStation 5 controller, of course, and you need the remap kit. I'll put the link in the description below. A marker. You are gonna need glue, or instead of glue you can use tape. A screwdriver with a Phillips head. A pry tool or something that looks like to open up the controller. If you look on the internet for a PlayStation 5 opening kit or a PlayStation 4 opening kit, then you will see various kits you can buy. You need a basic drill, not too powerful because you don't want to break up the controller. Just something so you can make the holes in the PlayStation 5 controller for the back buttons. Make sure to use something that's not too powerful before you break the controller. And as last and the most important one is a like. So you can drop a like on this video, because then everything will work perfectly when you start building your own PlayStation 5 SCUF controller. Okay, let's get started now and let's take the controller apart. As first step, you have to make sure that this black cover comes off first. And that's quite simple by first detaching it at the bottom with the pry tool. Once it's loose, you can just go gently back and forth and take it off the controller. Now we will detach both of the triggers, and we will do that again with the pry tool. Just put the pry tool in here at this side of the controller, then flip it back and forth and the trigger will come off easily. Now we are going to further disassemble the controller by loosening each screw with a screwdriver, and there are a total of 4 screws to take out as I just showed you. When you have unscrewed everything, you can take the controller apart, but do this gently because you don't want to break anything. It's very fragile. Take out the battery by pulling it lightly and then moving it back and forth. Once the battery is out, you can take off this black piece by taking out the screw with the screwdriver right here. And before you fully disassemble this black piece, you have to take something out first. There's a little, very small ribbon cable underneath, under the black piece. Make sure to take that out first. Alright, once that's off, you can take out all these 4 cable connectors. And sorry if I repeat too much, but do this also very gently. Another big tip for this is if your fingers are too thick or too big for you, you can also use a tweezer to take them out. That makes it more easy. Now we are in the next step, where we will attach the remap kit to the motherboard of the PlayStation 5 SCUF controller. The PlayStation 5 controller, and it will be a PlayStation 5 SCUF controller in the end. As you see, there are 2 holes in the ribbon cable, and then you can easily place it right here where it fits exactly. I found this one of the most difficult steps during this process, because you cannot glue or paste it on it, because then it cannot read anything anymore. And as you see, I'm messing around with it, but in the end I succeed. It will stay perfectly in place since you will place the motherboard on it, and those 2 black things will go through the motherboard. And use a screwdriver or something else to keep it in place when you're closing it. Or like what I just did, use a pair of extra hands, and this part will go way smoother. Once it's in place, just attach all the other ribbon cables back in the motherboard where it used to be. And now grab a little piece of double-sided tape to tape the remap kit on the motherboard. This can also be done with normal tape, just make sure to cut it small and make it double-sided like I did. I did it also like this because I didn't have double-sided tape. Now we are done with that, grab the black case that holds the battery and screw it back in place on the motherboard. Remember also that small annoying thing? You better remember, and I hope you haven't lost it, because we're gonna do the second hardest part of this video, and that's put it back in place, because it's a tricky part since it's very small, and if you have big fingers it's hard to put it back, since I have noticed that myself when I had some difficulties putting it back in place. Now just place the last thing back in the controller, and that's the battery, and just make sure that the side with the QR code on the battery is facing you. Okay, now everything is done within the controller, and we're just gonna make some holes in the back case of the controller for the back buttons. So grab your back case and a marker, mark it exactly right here where I'm marking it, and just a little bit between these two edges. Where you're gonna start with the drill, make sure to start with a small drill, and you don't want the hole to be too big because then you can't go back at it. So make sure to start with a small one and then just go to a bigger one. And while you're going to the bigger one, just fit the back buttons every time again in it, and if you're noticing that it fits exactly right, then you know you have the right hole. Another thing that's very important at this step is that you do not want to drill with too much power, or that your drill with too much power is, since it will break the controller case instantly, so do this careful. They said you have to attach the back button holder just with the screws, but I find that pretty hard, so just mark the two spots where you're gonna screw in, and then gently drill a little bit in it so it already has two holes in it, what will make it more easy to screw both of the screws in. Before we're gonna close the controller, we're gonna do one more thing, and that's setting the back buttons in the right place. You can either do this with tape or glue, but if you're gonna use glue, make sure to use hot glue, because then it's better when you're gonna glue it. But you can also do what I did, and that's just with tape. And if you're gonna do it like that, then tape it in the right place and also remember which is which. I've indicated one with the X and the other with circle, so I want the X button on the right side of the controller, so that's why I set it on the right side, and the circle button on the left side. Slide in the buttons in both holes you just drilled and then tape around it. It doesn't mind how much you use, just make sure that it fits right in place, and then test it a few times by pressing in the buttons. Now we're gonna close the controller and make sure to close it first from above, so it goes over the edges of the L2 button and the R2 button, and then close the controller by closing it down from the bottom side. Once you have done that, you just screw the four screws back in place. There need to go two screws below the controller on both same sides, and two where the L1 and R1 buttons need to go. And after this, you place the L1 and R1 buttons back in place by just pressing it gently in the controller. Again, like I said before, because if you press the wrong way or you're gonna press it sideways, then there is a chance it will break. This also applies to the black cap that goes on now. Make sure you slide the two points in first and then click the rest in. And now we finally arrived to the final step where we're gonna attach the back button presser. I don't know how to call it, but this goes on the controller. We're just gonna do that by screwing the two screws in both holes, and you need to do this with a little bit of force. Once you have placed the back button holder in place, you're done, and you now have your own PlayStation 5 SCUF controller.
Wow!
Like I said earlier in the video, very easy to do with just a few simple steps. If you want to see how the SCUF controller works, I have a video in the description below. If you're still watching this, then you're in here for a treat, since I'm going to give away this SCUF controller to one of you. Now you think, Voshku, you are crazy, why are you giving away this controller? Well, I'm so grateful for all the big support lately by every single one of you. And I do not also anymore play on the controller since I switched to keyboard and mouse. The only rule is that I'm only gonna give away this controller if we achieve 87 likes in total on this video, because that's how much this SCUF controller cost me in total. And if we don't make it, then that's a bummer, but then I will give it away in the next month. So if you want to enter the giveaway, make sure to follow the steps in the description below. That's basically it for this video, and I hoped it helped you out or you just enjoyed watching it. If you did, then make sure to drop a like to support the channel, and make sure to subscribe if you're new here. Also, if you are stuck with something or having difficulties with the build, please let me know in the comments and I will do my best to help you out. You can also join my Discord, where we have a nice community of around 300 people, and then you can ask your question in there. The link is in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.